So we are continuing the lesson, children. Yesterday we learned about the definition and how to find whether a given series of numbers is an arithmetic progression or not. And other things we learned yesterday, how to find the first term, how to find the common difference, etc. So today we'll continue the same with a screen share today. And in this, these most of the problems I'm discussing today are from exercise number 2 from the textbook. So those who have textbooks can also keep the textbooks with you so that you can understand which problem we are doing. Now you can understand the screen here. Let us hide this. Okay, now arithmetic progressions, and today's date also has come here. Now in this this is, let us consider this particular arithmetic progression: 100, 110, 120, 130 and 140. These are the numbers given in the arithmetic progression, and there are three dots at the end of this progression, meaning the progression is continuing or it is an infinite arithmetic progression. In a finite arithmetic progression, the dots will not be given. That means it is the number of terms in that is finite. It is stopping there. Whereas this particular arithmetic progression is continuing. It is an infinite arithmetic progression. Okay, let us closely observe what are all the terms here. See, the first term A or A1 is equal to 100, and the second term is 110, and the difference between the first term and the second term, that is 10, so that is common difference D. So once again we will understand what is second term. Second term is 110. It can be written as 100 plus 10. What is 100? That is A. That is A. And what is 10? That is nothing but D. So it is written as A plus D. Further, I want to write it as A plus 2 minus D. A plus 2 minus D. Now, third term, A3, is taken as 120, is given as 120. It is 100 plus 10 plus 10. It is A plus D plus D, or A plus 2D. A plus 2D. Further, that also can be written as A plus 3 minus 1 into D. A plus 3 minus 1 into D. Next, we have fourth term, 130. That is 100 plus 10 plus 10 plus 10. That is A plus D plus D plus D. That is A plus 3D. Further, I want to write it as A plus 4 minus D. Observe, children, here we have first term, of course, nothing is done. It is as it is kept as it is, A equal to 100. A2 is A plus D, or rather A plus 2 minus 1 into D. 2 minus 1. 2 minus 1. This is 2 here, 2 minus 1. And again, A3 is A plus 3 minus 1 into D. 3 minus 1 into D. Again, A4, number is 4 here, and the term, we are obtaining that fourth term as A plus 4 minus 1 into D. 4 minus 1 into D. Therefore, now if you continue the same, A5, A6, A7 like this, and An, or it is called nth term. Nth term in this series is obtained like this. An is equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. N minus 1 into D. Here 2 minus 1 because second term. 3 minus 1, third term. Fourth term, 4 minus 1. So nth term is N minus 1. So this is an important definition. This is a very important definition or very important formula for in this chapter. You have to learn this. You have to learn it by heart. Okay. Now, what is the nth term formula? An equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. All of you memorize this once and tell it in your mind once again. Okay. An equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. This is the formula you have to remember. Now, Now I am going to the third slide. I think you can note down the very important concept here, an equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. This explanation part you need not note down, only the formula, nth term formula expression you note down. Next, we will move on to the next slide. Without wasting any time, we straight away solve the problems from exercise 5.3 and learn how to use this nth term formula in solving the problems. So here is the question. Fill in the blanks in the following table. Given that A is the first term, D is the common difference, and An the nth term of the AB. Let us see the tabular form here. This is the tabular form. A, D, N, An. These are the things given in each arithmetic progression. First progression, first arithmetic progression, A equal to 7, D equal to 3, N equal to 8, An we don't know, we have to find. Let us find that. This is how you have to find. Given first term A equal to 7 and common difference D equal to 3 and thereby number of terms N equal to 8 that is given, we have to find what is the nth term in the series. We know that nth term of the series is An A plus N minus 1 into D, that is A, value of A is 7, you can understand, and N is 8, 8 minus 1 multiplied by D is 3. So 8 minus 1 is 7, 7 into 3 21, so 7 plus 21 28. Hence the nth term here An in this blank, what should come here? 28. What is this here? It is 28. You understand? So 28 is the answer there in the blank, right? Let us move on to the next question in this. So we need the tabular form. We keep the tabular form there in the next slide also. We keep the tabular form and then let us do the second question step by step. A equal to 18, first term is given in the second this one, you can see, and D is not given. N equal to given, An equal to 0, N equal to 10, and we need to find what is D. And we know nth term of the series of an AP series or AB is given by An equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Therefore, An is 0 given, and in place of A, I am writing 18 because it is 18 given there. N minus 1, 10 minus 1 into D. So, these are the two things given. By substitution, we put all the things except D, all other numbers are known. So D is the variable to be found. We solve like linear equations in one variable, very simple to solve. 18 you send this side, this the other side, because it is a free number. So 18 equal to 10 minus 1 90, therefore D equal 90 equal to 18, or D equal to 18 by 9. This is by transposing, of course 9 is transposed to this side, and D equal to 2. Okay, now you can note down this particular step here, this particular question you note down quickly. Okay, shall we move on to the next one now?
Yes, sir.
Okay, that's good.
Sir, first two slides can you show, sir? First, I will take screenshot, sir.
Okay, one second. This is the first question. Okay? Right.
Thank you, sir.
And this is the first slide. Okay? First slide.
Okay, sir.
Alright. Then this question also we have discussed now. We are moving on to the third question in this, or the third smaller question in the tabular form. Tabular form I kept as it is. See, A is not given, D is given, N is given, An is given. Here you can observe all these things. So what is given one by one, we write common difference is 3, n number of terms is 18, and we have a n equal to minus 5. Again, a equal to how much is the question. We apply for AP series or AP, the nth term formula, a n equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. The available numbers are whatever is given. Given numbers will substitute in this. By substituting, a n equal to minus 5. So, minus 5 is written. A is not given. A plus n is 18. 18 minus 1 into d is minus 3. So, minus 5 equal to a plus 17 into minus 3. 17 3s are 51. So, that we will write in the next step. So, minus 5 equal to a minus 51. So, now we will write a minus 51 this side and 51 this side. A minus 51 equal to minus 5, or a equal to 51 minus 5, it is 46. So, here in the third, this one, we need 46 here. What is the number there? 46. Okay. So, it should be like this, in this. 46 is the number there. Right. Next question. Shall I move on to the next one?
Yes, sir.
Okay. Yes, sir.
That's right. So, please note down quickly, what is to be noted down is, write from the equation you write. From here you start writing, so that it will be easy for you to note down. Okay, all other things are given in the textbook itself, that those need not be noted down. Right, next question now. We have the same tabular form again. Here you observe carefully, because the decimals are given here. A is minus 18.9, D equal to 2.5, number of terms is not given, AN is 3.6, that is given. So, first term A equal to minus 18.9 and common difference is 2.5 and nth term in the series is 3.6 and we have to find how many terms are there in that series or in that arithmetic progression. Now, we know that nth term for a series of arithmetic progression or an arithmetic progression, it is an equal to a plus n minus 1 into d. So, in this, we substitute all the values which are known to us. An is 3.6, we have noted, and a minus 18.9, n minus 1 into 2.5. Okay, now 3.6 plus 18.9, I brought that side, n minus 1 into 2.5 now. Now, when we add these two, you get 22.5, 9 plus 6, 5, and of course 15, that is 15, 1, 19, and 3, 22. 22.5 equal to n minus 1 into 2.5. Now, this 2.5 will divide 22.5 by 2.5. So, what are we doing? We are going to divide 22.5 by 2.5. Okay. These two are decimals with one decimal place in each. One decimal place here, one decimal place here, also one decimal place. So, multiply each of them by 10. Here also, I mean the numerator as well as the denominator, I am multiplying by 10. So that this will become 225. The numerator is becoming 225 and by 25 now. It is 25. Following. 225. How many times of 25 will divide? How many times of 25 is 225? It is 9 times. So, 9 is the answer this side. So, n minus 1 is 9. Therefore, okay, here I have to draw neatly. I will erase this. Okay. This is n minus 1 equal to 9 now. Therefore, n equal to, this one I will bring this side, n equal to 9 plus 1, 10. So what is the value of n here? N equal to 10. So in this blank, we should have 10. Understand? So this is how we found what is the value. So those who want, note down quickly, this whatever explanation I am writing with a red colored pen, not required. If you want, you can note down, otherwise it is all rough work, of course. Okay? Right, shall we move on to the next one?
Yes, sir.
Yeah, very good.
Yes, sir.
Next one is rather easy. Let us keep the tabular form again. N equal to 10, of course, we have written. Let us move on to the fifth question here. A equal to 3.5, D equal to 0, and N equal to 105. What a big number. A and B we have to find. Children, I showed this example yesterday. D can be 0 also, nothing wrong in it. It can be negative, it can be positive, it can be 0 also. But if it is 0, the first term, whatever is the first term, will be the last term also. It goes on and on. Because 0 is added to any number, the same number is the result. That you have to keep in mind. But how to prove it logically? Let us follow this definition of nth term as well the formula for nth term and prove this one. Nth term of AP is equal to AN. Here AN is to be found here. A is there, D is there, N is there. So we know the formula AN equal to A plus N minus 1 into D. Therefore, in that everything will substitute except AN. A 3.5, N 105 minus 1 into 0. Some number multiplied by 0 is 0. Therefore, AN is 0 plus 3.5 or simply it is 3.5. So this is the question here, fifth question. So all these are first question number one. Question number one, we discussed question number one from exercise 5.2 now. Now, second question in this exercise is just like multiple choice questions, multiple choice, but you have to work out. Try that one on your own, children, later on. And we move on to the third question here. It is an important one. Let us see how to do the third question now, step by step. Shall I go to that slide, next slide?
Yes, sir.
Very
yes,
good.
Sir.
I think you have noted.
Yes, sir.
Right. This is question number three. Again, there yes, are sir. Five small questions in this. In each of the following, there is one or more missing terms are there in each of the following arithmetic progressions. We have to find those missing terms. And in place of every missing term, a box is drawn. So let us do that one now. First one, of course, it is A is 2 and A2 is not given. A3 is given 26. So this one is you have to keep in mind. A equal to 26. A3 is 26. A2 is not given. A is 2. So let us write that one. Let the terms be A, A plus D, A plus 2D. Then A plus 2D equal to 26. Why I am telling A plus 2D? In the very first, in the beginning of this lesson, you understood A, by adding 1D to the previous one, you are getting second term. 2D is, if you add, you will get the third term. Is it not? So A plus D, A plus 2D are the terms here. So A plus 2D equal to 26, third term is 26. Therefore, we substitute the value of A in this equation to get the value of D as 26 equal to 2 plus 2D. 2 means that is A. That is therefore, right, 2D equal to 24 or D equal to simply 12. D equal to 12 now. When D equal to 12, the missing term is A plus 2D, A plus 24, A plus D, that is A plus 12, that is 14. So the missing term is A plus D, the second term now. Second term is missing. Second term here, the second term, A plus D is missing. So A equal to 2. We know that, and D equal to 12, A equal to 2, therefore 2 plus 14, 2 plus 12 equal to 14. That is the missing term. I think you got the answer. You got the, you understood this one. Right, Prabhavati?
Yes, sir.
Prabhavati, you are asking something? Prabhavati, want something to be answered? No.
No, sir.
No, okay. Right, Ganesri, are you following? Ganesri?
Yes, sir.
Okay, okay. Chandu? Chandu?
Sir, following, sir.
Very good, very good. Right. Now, let us move on to the second question here. Question number 3, second one. First term itself is given in terms of a box. Second term is 13. Third term is box again. Fourth term is 3. So, second and fourth terms are given here. So, it is an important one. Listen clearly. So, what is given? Second term is 13. Fourth term is 3. And what is first term A? What is fourth term A3? So, first term, we'll write a formula for the second term. That is, A plus N minus 1 into D is the formula for nth term. So, second term is A plus 2 minus 1 or A plus D. A plus D, that is 13. That is the first equation for us. So, here, A plus D equal to 13. Here, this is the second term here. We obtained the second term, A plus 13. A plus 13, that is the equation, first equation. Now, in the second equation, like in the second, this one, we consider fourth term is 3. Therefore, A4 equal to A plus 4 minus 1 into D, A plus 3D, that is 3. So, A plus fourth term equal will become A plus 3D, that is this one. So, A plus 3D equal to 3, A plus D equal to 13. Remember these two equations. We are going to solve them in the next slide. So, from the first equation, if you subtract the second equation, A plus D minus A plus 3D or A minus 3D will be equal to 13 minus 3. So, let us do that in the next one to obtain the value of D as well as A. It is just like solving linear equations in two variables. Two equations are given and you have to follow the equations here now. Now, let us understand how to follow this. Let us see. A plus D minus A plus 3D I am doing. First equation minus second equation equal to 13 minus 3. A plus D minus A minus 3D equal to 10. Or minus 2D, A and A are cancelled here. Here A is cancelled with minus A here. And D minus 3D minus 2D equal to 10. Or we have D equal to minus 5. This is an important conclusion. Next, we want first term and the third term. So, substitute this one in the first equation. Then, 13 equal to A plus minus 5 or A equal to this 5 I will bring this side. When minus 5 is brought this side, it will be plus 5. A equal to 13 plus 5, that is 18. That is 18. So, when A is 18 and D is 5, can't we find the fourth third term? A3 equal to A plus 3 minus 1 into D or A plus 2D, that is A plus A, 18 plus D, 2 into minus 5. So, that is A, 18 minus 10, that is 8. So, the missing terms are 18 and 8. I think you got the answer now, right? I think you, can you note down?
Yes, sir.
Okay.
Yes, sir.
That's right, that's right. Nikhil, are you following? Nikhil?
Yes, sir.
Okay, finish writing. Now we move on to the next question. Now we solve this one. It is 18 here and 8 here. Is it not? 18 and 8 only, now we got in the previous slide, 18 and 8. So, now fourth question here. or I let me erase this one. Let me erase this. Just a moment. Now the next this one. Oh, it is not. We'll wait a second, let it respond. Now you can observe the third one. It is simple. A5, A2 is not given, A3 is not given, A4 is 9 and half. So that we will do now. Of course it is already 11:52, we can finish only that much now. Let me close this and come back again. Let me see this. Okay, wait a second, it is opening. I think this is the question here. Yes, slideshow. Right, question number 3 we are doing now. A is 5, B, A2 and A3 are not given, A4 is given. So the whole answer I am putting it once for all and explain it. An equal to a plus n, n minus 1 into d it should be. Of course n plus 1 is written, forget about that. It's a wrong one, I will take a pen, correct it here. This is minus, children, minus. A plus n minus 1 into d, that is the right one. Now, so a plus n minus 1 into d, that is 4 minus 1 into d. So here A4 is 9 and half. 9 and half means 2 nines are 18 plus 1, 19 by 2. When you take it into an improper fraction, that is 5, A is 5 plus 4 minus 1, 3D. So 19 by 2 minus 5 will be 3D, will be equal to 3 times of D. So again take LCM, 2 5s are 10. So 19 minus, actually it is 19 by 2 minus, sorry, minus 5, then 2 is LCM here, 2 is LCM, when 2 is LCM, here 19 minus 2 5s are 10. 19 minus 5 how much? 19 minus 10 how much? It is 9 equal to 9 by 2. 9 by 2. 3D equal to 9 by 2. So when 3 times of D, 3 times of D is 9 by 2. 1 time of D means this 3 will be set that side. So 9 by 2 divided by 3, meaning it is into 1 by 3, into 1 by 3. So this 3 divides this one like this 3 times, 3 by 2 now. So D equal to 3 by 2. When D is 3 by 2, A2 equal to, here A2, this is A2, A2 equal to A plus D, 5 plus 3 by 2, it is again 13 by 2, and A3 equal to A plus 2D, 2 times of D, that is 2, 2 cancelled here, this 2 are cancelled, 5 plus 3, 8. So, the missing terms are 13 by 2 and 8. Got it? Any doubt? Geeta, are you following? Harinarayana, Kanishka?